रोल नंबर वन।
यस मैम।
टू।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थ्री।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फोर।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फाइव।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
सिक्स।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
सेवन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
एट।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
नाइन। रोल नंबर नाइन। रोल नंबर नाइन एब्सेंट। टेन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
इलेवन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेल्व।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टीन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फोर्टीन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फिफ्टीन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
सिक्सटीन। रोल नंबर सिक्सटीन। सिक्सटीन एब्सेंट। सेवेंटीन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
एटीन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
नाइनटीन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी वन। ट्वेंटी वन। रोल नंबर ट्वेंटी वन। ट्वेंटी
टू। प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी
थ्री। प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी फोर।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी फाइव।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी सिक्स। ट्वेंटी सेवन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी एट।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
ट्वेंटी नाइन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी वन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी टू।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी थ्री। थर्टी थ्री। थर्टी फोर।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी फाइव।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी सिक्स।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी सेवन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी एट।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
थर्टी नाइन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फोर्टी।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फोर्टी वन।
यस मैम।
फोर्टी टू।
यस मैम।
फोर्टी थ्री।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
फोर्टी फोर।
यस मैम।
फोर्टी फाइव। रोल नंबर फोर्टी फाइव।
मैम रोल नंबर सिक्सटीन प्रेजेंट।
रोल नंबर आई एम जस्ट आस्किंग नाउ। रोल नंबर फोर्टी फाइव। रोल नंबर फोर्टी फाइव प्रेजेंट। रोल नंबर फोर्टी फाइव एब्सेंट। ओके नाउ विच वन।
दिस रोल नंबर फोर्टी फाइव दिस माइक वाज नॉट वर्किंग फॉर स्लो नेटवर्क।
शोभन नायक।
यस मैम।
ओके सो फोर्टी फाइव प्रेजेंट। रोल नंबर सिक्सटीन।
यस मैम।
विक्रम कुमार पंडित।
यस मैम।
रोल नंबर नाइन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
अभिषेक चौधरी।
यस मैम।
सो व्हाई यू हैव नॉट गिवन अटेंडेंस अर्लियर।
मैम आई हैव जॉइंड लेट मैम।
रोल नंबर ट्वेंटी वन।
प्रेजेंट मैम।
रोल नंबर थर्टी थ्री। रोल नंबर थर्टी थ्री एब्सेंट। रोल नंबर थर्टी थ्री आई एम मेकिंग दिस एब्सेंट। रोल नंबर थर्टी थ्री। Yes, I want to inform you all because I have to just report the number of students absentees, the roll number of the absentees to the department just after my class. So for that, I am calling the roll number and I am just giving the absence to the roll number 33. But what you told you all, that you all have to fill the Google form, because this is for my data and this is for your marks, everything, that Google form. And if you are not filling the data there, then you will be absent when I will consider whole, when I will arrange the your attendance for the whole semester, then you all will be problem. Who are not filling the form, then you have a great problem later. So be cautious about that. And you can't fill up 2 attendance a day, because today's attendance you have to fill up only for that day. Because if you are thinking that yesterday you have not given the presence in Google form, so yesterday attendance and today's attendance you are giving in the same way, so 2 times you are filling the attendance, so I will not consider. If in a particular day I get 2 attendance, so I will not consider, I will only consider only 1 attendance. So in the same day and as early as possible you have to fill up your Google form. And the timing, that is in what time you are filling the form, that is also shown is Google form. So if I get that you are filling at night, if you are filling in the evening, then I will, for that you will be punished later, and you will see what effect you will get for that. So be punctual while filling up the Google form, and fill up within 1 hour of class that Google form. And this is mandatory for you, but because this is the only data, written data that I have, and I will go through it whenever I will consider the internal marks. And then you will have problem while not filling the form. Understand all the students? What I am getting, that in my class presence is, I say only one student is absent, but in that is when I'm checking Google form for a particular day, say getting 8 students are absent in that form. So you are that will hamper your marks, because attendance on attendance marks is there, and you will not get marks. So be very cautious filling up the Google form. So I will only consider the written data. And there are 2 reasons that I call by roll number. First thing, just after my class, I have to submit the absentee report to the department. And also here I call by name. That means when, if you are not present in my class and you are filling up the Google form later, that you are present in that class, so that I can count that total number of students present in my class and the number of presence in Google form, that will be same. So for that reason, I take the attendance every day, that what are the absentee roll numbers. So these are the 2 reasons that I will verify when I will check the Google form, and I have the absentee roll numbers here. So I will just tally the 2 roll numbers so that no extra attendance is given in Google form. But your last, that is very much important for you, that you have to fill up the Google form every day within 1 hour of class. And if you are missing, then you are also missing your marks. And last semester there was no exam there, and totally was dealing with the internal marks. And if it happens for you also, then you all have a big problem in marks. Understand everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
And last day I told you that I will give one assignment, but due to my health problem, it was not possible for me to give the assignment. So I will give a note that I have given the assignment there in Google Classroom. So today or tomorrow I will give the assignment, and also last date of the assignment will be given. And no need to give the attendance in Google Classroom. It was first time the attendance, I asked the attendance, because to clarify that you are in Google Classroom or not, total number of students. Let me check what are the number of students in Google Classroom. Last day I also checked. Only 38 students are here, 44, okay. So one student is absent. Total 44 attendance is showing in Google Classroom. Total 44 students are showing in Google Classroom. So one student is absent. And just that student I'm asking, just enter into the Google Classroom as early as possible. So for my class, only 33 is absent. So LCS circuit last day I discussed, probably the last portion it is remaining. So it will take only 10 minutes or 5 minutes more. So this thing I discussed, this is the expression of current I equal to V0 by Z. So you may get numerical from this, numerical problem. You have to remember always omega 0 equal to 1 by root over LC. And I0, it is given by V0 by Z. And at resonance, omega L equal to 1 by omega C. And for that, Z becomes R. So the impedance of the circuit becomes purely resistive. And this is the condition of resonance. So it may be given in a short answer type question. The impedance of the circuit becomes inductive, number one option. Impedance of the circuit becomes resistive. Third option, inductive and resistance both. In this way, different options you may get, that at resonance, the current in the circuit becomes resistive. This is the only answer. Now, the variation of current amplitude as well as impedance with the frequency omega of the applied AC voltage, that is shown in the figure, next figure. If the resistance of the circuit is reduced, the resonance curve becomes sharper. Earlier, I discussed that is what is sharpness of resonance. Sharpness of resonance. Now here, for resonance in LCS circuit, the resistance of the circuit is reduced. If the resistance is reduced, the resonance curve becomes sharper. So if the R value is decreasing, the resonance curve becomes sharper. The more quickly the current amplitude falls for changes of frequency from omega zero, the sharper is the resonance. The sharpness of resonance is defined by quality factor. Now I'm coming. This is the graph. This is the graph. This is R1 resistance. This is R2 resistance. And this is R3 resistance. So this is this R. This R value. I0 depends on R. Now if R is increasing, then what is written here? That is the resonance curve. If R is reduced, the resonance curve becomes sharper. So resonance curve is sharper if R value is less. So here, this is here you can see that is R1 is less than R2, less than R3. So which one is which resistance is smallest resistance here? Tell me, which one is smallest resistance from this curve? Which one is smallest? Tell me. Showing by just sign.
R1 is smallest.
And this is the value of I0. I0 is highest for which? This value, peak value? For smallest resistance, R1 is the smallest, so this is the highest value. And this is the R2 value. This is the R2 resistance, and what is the peak? Here. And for R3 resistance, R3 is greater than all these three. R1 and R2, R3 is greater than R1 and R2. So here, this value is less. Now you can see that here this curve is sharper. Here this curve is sharper. This is comparatively flatter with respect to this. And this is also same. This is flatter with respect to this curve. So sharper, though resistance is less, the sharp is the nature of the curve. The curve is more sharper. Now quality factor is which? Quality factor is omega 0 divided by omega 2 minus omega 1. Omega 2 and omega 1 are the lower and upper half frequencies. That means at which power dissipation in the circuit drops to one half of its resonance value. So here it is, this is the curve, this is the, if it is half value. So omega and omega 2 are the lower and upper half power frequencies. So come here again, Q equal to, we know that is omega by 2k. This is the definition, actually quality factor. This is the definition is omega by 2k. And k value, we actually know it. K value is the value of 2k that is given by R by L. So I have given this value. So actually, you know, omega Q quality factor equal to omega L by R. So as 2K equal to R by L. So this is the value of quality factor. Now here for this curve, here this is the I0 value is shown. And if I plot here impedance, this is the plot of impedance. This is the just opposite graph it is. So this is the value of impedance. And you can see at omega 0, that is at resonance frequency, the value of impedance is what? This is the just U-shaped curve. U-shaped sharper curve. This is the impedance curve. So impedance curve is shown. And for omega 0 is the frequency, that is resonance frequency. Now at omega 0, what is the value of impedance? Minimum. What is the value of impedance? This is minimum.
Minimum.
So this is the value. This is the minimum value. So impedance is changing in this way. Along say here, what is the value of impedance? So along y-axis, see, I have two curves are plotted here in the same graph. I am taking, first is I0 is plotted along this direction and omega is plotted along this direction. And if I0 is along the y-axis and omega is along the x-axis, then first curve is this curve, this shaped curve, this three, R1, R2, R3 is shown here. These are the three curves. Then for the next set, this curve is also superposed here. So for the next set, what is plotted? Z is plotted along y-axis and omega is along the same axis. So two variable things are there in along the y-axis. One is I0 and another is Z. So two graphs are superposed here. So if we plot Z along the y-axis and omega along the x-axis, now the graph is this graph I'm plotting. So you can separately also plot. If you want to plot Z versus omega, that is how the impedance is varying, then you will only draw Z along y-axis and omega along x-axis. Now you will only draw this graph. Then you will only draw this graph. So impedance value is minimum where at resonance, because you know that impedance become fully resistive at resonance frequency. And here, that is the maximum value we have, and it increasing in both the side. So this is the nature of the impedance with the frequency. And another graph is drawn, that is I0 versus frequency. The current, how it is varying, how the current is varying. So you can see that at resonance frequency, current is maximum. And for three different resistances, the current is shown. If the resistance is small, the current is higher. Then here current is lower and it is again lower than this graph. So there are two different graphs that is shown here. Now another thing that is very important, relaxation time. It is defined as the time taken to fall the energy of the damped oscillatory motion to 1 by E times of its initial value. So you just remember this expression because numerical problems are given. So tau equal to what? Relaxation time, that is 1 by k. It is the time taken to fall the energy of the damped oscillatory motion to 1 by e times of its initial value. And it is given by this. So tau equal to relaxation time equal to 1 by k. And it is here equal to 2L by R. And k value, you know, actually k equal to R by 12. So I have given the value. So relaxation time equal to 2L by R. So these two formulas are very important. That is, what is the expression of quality factor? This is omega L by R. And another expression of relaxation time, this is 2L by R. So you will get numerical problems from this. So LCR values will be given and you have to find out the relaxation time and the time period. A relaxation time and the quality factor. I will give numerical problems in your assignment and you have to solve it from this portion. So numerical problems will be given in your assignment and these formulas are very much important. So these are the remaining part that I have discussed and this graph is also very important. So two graphs, I0 versus omega graph and another is impedance versus omega graph. Okay, so here force vibration is ending. I'm ending force vibration here. Now, according to your this class is about the vector calculus. I will start the vector calculus today. So I'm just going to that slide. I have ordered my graphic tablet pen. Okay, so tomorrow or the next day tomorrow I will get it. So after that I will use that, and for the numericals or the this portion vector, so up to for next to that, I mean up to that you have to wait. Now just I am coming to first introduction to vector calculus. Now gradient, what do you mean by gradient? Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, the gradient, the vector differential operator, del, it is written as this. This is the name is gradient or del. That is equal to, or grad, we can write this, the name. So, this is equal to I hat del del x plus J hat del del y plus K hat del del z. This vector operator possesses properties analogous to those of ordinary vectors. So this is one vector. So this is operator, vector operator. It is useful in defining three quantities which arise in practical applications and are known as gradient, divergence and curl. So by this vector operator, that is del operator, we can define three things. That is, one is gradient, another is divergence and curl. The operator, this sign, it is also known as nabla. So this is the form of this operator nabla. This is equal to I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat del del z. This is vector differential operator del. Now this del operator, from this del operator we can write three things. First one is gradient, second one is divergence, and the third one is curl. Using this vector differential operator, differential operator del, using this we can express gradient, divergence and curl. These are the three things. Now if phi, that is a function of x, y and z, be defined and differentiable at each point x, y, z in a shortened region of space, that is the gradient of phi, then the gradient of phi or grad phi, it is written as this. What I am taking, phi I am taking that it is defined and differentiable at each point x, y, z in a shortened region of space. So phi defines a differentiable scalar field, then the gradient of phi. So this is scalar function. Phi is scalar function. So the grad of phi, that is defined as, so what is this thing? I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat del del z. What is this? What I told this operator?
Gradient.
Del operator. Actually, this is what? Del operator or nabla. Okay. Now, when I am writing this, this is the name is gradient of phi. When I am writing it with some scalar function, then I'm just writing it gradient of phi. Actually, this is the operator. This is the del operator. Now, if I write that this is gradient, or this is when this is written like this, this is gradient of phi. Then if I give one, again, I will use that thing for gradient, then divergence, and also for curl. But when it is written with scalar function in this way, then this is meaning is gradient of phi or grad phi. So this is the form of the operator that I have written here. I had del del x plus j had del del y plus k had del del z. You know i j k, these are the unit vectors. You know that is x, that is r. If r is one vector, then r can be written as what? I hat x plus, say r is a vector in with respect to i j k. How I can write if r is a vector?
X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap.
Okay, so in this way I can write. Now this is here, so same unit vector I hat, j hat and k hat along x, y, z. So this is the form I hat del del x. So you can write it later or in a front portion, no problem. I hat del del x you can write, or del del x of I hat, no problem for that. So del del x of I hat plus del del y of j hat plus del del z of k hat. So what is this portion? This portion I have written. Then phi, as it is I have written. So when this del del x is operating on phi, then what I am getting? So I am getting del phi by del x, then del phi by del y plus del phi by del z. And in play in this with here it is I hat is here, and in the second one it is j hat is here, and in the third one it is k hat is here. So grad of phi, when I am writing grad phi, so what is the form? Del phi by del x I hat plus del phi by del y j hat plus del phi by del z k hat. Now say when I am taking grad of phi, so grad phi defines a vector field. So you are getting I cap, j cap, k cap with this. So a total value, that is grad phi, it is a vector field. The component of grad phi in the direction of a unit vector a hat is given by grad phi dot a hat. Remember this, the component of grad phi in the direction of a unit vector a hat is given by grad phi dot a hat. This is called the directional derivative of phi. So what is the directional derivative of phi? That is grad phi dot a hat, and this is the called the directional derivative of phi in the direction of a hat. Physically, this is the rate of change of phi, that is at x, y, z in the direction a hat. So this is the rate of change of phi. Gradient means what? Rate of change, that rate of change of that function, scalar function. So physically, this is the meaning, this is the rate of change of phi at x, y, z in the direction a hat. So in this way we can represent grad phi. So gradient means the rate of change of phi. So remember this one. But before, so I have this geometric interpretation of grad phi that I will discuss. But before that, I'm just giving you one problem here. Find grad phi if phi equal to ln of mod of r. Ln of mod of r. First problem. So grad phi, that is equal to what? Grad phi, we have to find out, and phi is ln r. So this problem. So r is what? Vector. This is written in bold. So what is the meaning of this? Vector r. What is the meaning of this? Vector r, but the mod of this r. So r is vector r. R is what? X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. So r is this. So r value is this. Now when you will take mod of this quantity, so mod of this quantity is what? So mod, so this straight line, two straight lines, in between a two straight line r is written, vector r is written. What is the meaning of this? This is mod r. Now what is the value of mod r? You know, say r equal to, say, give me answer. if r equal to 2i hat plus 2j hat plus 2k hat, let r equal to 2i hat plus 2j hat plus 2k hat. What is the value of mod r?
Root over of 2 square plus 2 square plus 2 square.
Ma'am, 2 root 3.
No, don't. Just I want to know, you know, and know or don't know. So don't need to calculate. So I want to know if it is r equal to 2i cap plus 2j cap plus 2k cap, then the mod of r, that is, or anything, mod of a, mod of b, any vector that is equal to 2i hat plus 2j hat plus 2k hat, then mod of this equal to root over 2 square plus 2 square plus 2 square. So this is the mod value. In the same way, this is the vector, so I have written the mod value here. Then mod of r equal to this. Now phi is what is given? Phi is what? Ln of mod r. So if you take ln of mod r, then what you will write? Ln of root over x square plus y square plus z square. Ln of root over x square plus y square plus z square. So what I can write this?
1 by 2 ln.
So actually this is the power is half. The power is x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power half. So when I will take mod ln of this, ln of this thing, so half will come to the front. So half is there, then ln of this thing. Okay, so this is ln of this thing. So actually phi, then I have this one. So phi, actually I have this one. Now what I have, actually phi was given as phi equal to ln of mod r. So r we know, mod r I have written, then phi I have calculated. Phi is half of ln of x square plus y square plus z square. So this is my phi. Now question is what? You have to calculate what? Grad phi. You have to calculate grad phi, and two phis are there in number A. Actually, I am discussing, so I am just concerned with that number A. So grad phi. Then grad. This is that actually. This you, if you can, it is written in bold sign. So in your copy, no need to write it in bold. In books, you will get. And this is the image from the book, so it is bold. And whenever you will write it, you will give one which sign. How will you write it? You will write it like
an arrow sign.
This sign, nabla. Okay. So you will write it like this. In this way, you will write it, an arrow you will give. So whenever you will write it in your copy, then you will write grad phi. You will write this sign and there one vector. So arrow sign you will write. Arrow. Always you will write it by arrow. So grad of phi, that is equal to half, then grad of ln x square plus y square plus z square. So this is, now what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? I had del x plus
j had
what del is del the meaning of this? I had del x plus j hat
del y
plus k hat
del z.
Okay, so I had del x, it is written here. I had del x of what? This one, ln of this. Then j hat del y, ln of this. Plus k hat del z, ln of this. Now differentiate this. Now del x of ln of something. Ln of something means 1 by that thing. So 1 by x square plus y square plus z square. And then del x of what? 2x. Del x of 2x, del x of x square. So what I will write? 2x. Then in the same way, del y of this. So 1 by that thing written here. Then del y of y square. Because this is not the function. So del y of y square. I'm getting 2y. Then del y of last. 1 by that thing into del y of z square. So 2z. So ultimately, what I have written x square and y square plus z square, this is the common part given outside. Now this half cancels, half cancels, half cancels with the external, this half. So what remains? X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap here divided by this. So what is this numerator? What is this?
R.
R.
R. So this is vector R by R square. So what is this? This is vector R by R square. Understand? So what is the grad phi? So phi equal to ln of mod R. Ln of mod R. So what is, if given phi equal to ln of mod R, then what is grad phi? Grad phi is R by R square. This is vector R. And this is the R means what? This R, mod R. This is the, see here. It is not bold because it is mod R. So this is R. Actually, R is this root over x square plus y square plus z square. If you square it, then you will get x square plus y square plus z square. This is R square. So vector R by R square. Okay. Now take the screenshot of this, this one, second. Take the screenshot of this. Then I am saying what to do. Take the screenshot of this. Acha, can you all see the whiteboard from here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You can see the whiteboard. Ma'am. Okay. Actually, I have no pen, graphics pen, but my laptop is touch screen. So I'm just trying to calculate this here. So what is the second one that you have taken? Grad of, so this is the meaning I was saying, that always write this symbol, okay? So with vector sign. So what is the meaning of this? I hat del del x plus what?
J hat del del y
plus J hat
del del x.
Okay. So what I'm now writing, grad. So always write is like this, grad of phi. So phi is what in the second portion? I told you to take the screenshot. So phi is what?
1 by R.
Tell me, 1 by R. Okay, 1 by R. So actually this is the mod value. So what is what I will write here now? Actually, in the same place, what I will write, that I'm writing equal to, equal to, I am writing what? Gradient of what? 1 by R. So what I will write? root over x square plus y square plus z square. Okay. So what is the value of r? R is root over x square plus y square plus z square. This is the mod value. Now, this thing, I am going to the next slide. Now, grad of what? Grad of, I'm just writing like this, x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power, what I will write?
Minus half.
Minus 1 by 2.
Okay. Now, this thing. Now, what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this I'm writing. What is the meaning of this? I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat actually I have no graphics plane, so it is I just by finger I'm writing to my touch screen, so the handwriting is not okay, so no problem, you will understand. K hat del del z and here bracket. So what is the meaning? This is the meaning of grad or gradient. Okay, now after that what you can see, phi, what is this? This is phi. You can see no vector is there. Phi is a scalar function. Here there is no I hat, j hat, k hat. It is x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power minus half. So no vector is there. So grad of phi, that is I writing, then this is the meaning of this, this grad, this is the symbol. Then what I will write after this, this, then x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power minus half. Okay. Now, this del del x. So this del del x will operate. Just now next step is differentiation. You have to differentiate. So how you will differentiate? So del del x of this whole thing. Okay, del del x of this whole thing, then how will you write it? So minus half. Now del del x of this. Just a minute. Now what I'm writing? I'm writing I hat. Then del del x of what? X square plus y square plus z square. Whole to the power what? Half.
Minus. Okay.
Plus what? J hat del del y. Then x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power what? Minus half. Plus k cap del del z x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power what? Minus half. Okay, clear up to this?
Yes.
Okay, then what is my task? I have to only differentiate. And you know how to differentiate del del x of this thing. Now, what you will get in this place? Minus half. Then x square plus y square plus z square minus half minus 1. Power mein kya hoga? Bolo. Differentiation ke baad.
Minus 3 by 2.
Okay, so here when del del y of this thing, then again in the power, what you will get? Minus? 3 by 2, okay. And here, again, minus 3 by 2. When you are differentiating with Z. So, this is the common term. What is the common term? From all the differentiation? X square plus Y square plus Z square? Whole to the power? Minus 3 by 2.
Minus 3 by 2.
It is the common term. Then again, if you, and again, the common term is minus half. What is the common term? you are differentiating del del of this thing, so all you are getting the minus half again, all this whole to the power minus 3/2. So minus half is always here, this term and this term. So you are differentiating. So minus half and x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power minus 3/2. This is the common term. Now del del x next will operate on which? X square. So what you will get? 2x. What you will get? 2x. Here del del will operate, del del y will operate on y square. What you will get? 2y.
2y.
Del del z will operate on z square. What you will get? 2z.
2z.
Okay. So I'm going to next slide. Now, so ultimate answer, you what you will get? Grad phi equal to. So what you will get? You are getting the answer as, just check it. Minus
f phi.
Minus y
cap
j cap
j cap
minus z
minus k cap by x y square plus z square whole to the power minus 3/2.
This is the answer. Okay, so what is the numerator value? X I hat plus y j hat plus z k hat. What is this vector? R
minus r.
And this is what? X square plus y square z square denominator. Actually, root of r is r. X square plus y square plus z square root. This is r. So r to the power?
3.
What?
3.
Okay. Now clear this problem. So grad phi equal to what?
R by r cube.
Vector r by? Vector r. This is vector r. This is not. This is mod value. This is vector r by r cube. Okay. So in this way, in gradient, what type of problem we will get? One scalar function will be given, like phi. Say phi is this thing. Then you have to calculate grad phi. Okay. Now grad phi you will calculate. In the place of grad, you will write what you will write. I had del del x plus j had del del y. That I have going to the previous slide. In this way. So this is the gradient. I had del del x plus j had del del y plus k had del del z. So this is the gradient, and phi is given here like this. So just, but that means here important is you have to differentiate. You, if you know differentiation, then you can find out the gradient. So only thing, you have to differentiate carefully. Okay. Is this my whiteboard work is helpful to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
So I tried just with this whiteboard. Okay, the same the PPT I will give you, and my next class, in my next class what I will do, I will explain the physical significance of gradient. What do you mean by gradient? Actually the question that you will get only the this type of numerical problems that is given in this portion, from this portion, but you should know what you are calculating gradient. You should know what do you mean by gradient and its physical significance. So I am just now sharing this one. Now is this screen, initial screen is visible? From yes, where sir. I told you to do the screenshot. Okay. So this thing, this problem, the first problem it was, and the second problem that I have derived. So these are the two problems, and next thing, next part, that is electric potential and electric field. What do you mean by how this gradient? Actually, electric field is written as equal to minus grad V. That I will say later, is tomorrow. So these two problems I have discussed. Now tomorrow, what I will discuss, this portion, geometric interpretation of grad phi. So I will give you the note. So just read it carefully. Then I will define it tomorrow. So geometric interpretation of grad phi, and what do you mean by this, and then after that electric potential and field, and one another problem is also here, that is grad of r to the power n. Prove that n r to r to the power n minus 2 r. So if it is also given in notes, so go through it and do it yourself. You know how it is to calculate. Grad is I had del del x plus j had del del y plus k had del del z, r to the power n. R is what? R is this, root over this, x square plus y square plus z square whole to the power n. So grad of this, whole to the power n, it is half, so n by 2. So nothing to, no problem here. So only we will write I hat del del x plus k hat del del y plus k, j hat del del y plus k hat del del z, and only to differentiate. And ultimately it is proof. It is the proof. N r to the power n minus 1 into r vector. So this is the proof. Another problem, it is here on directional derivative. These problems I will discuss. I'm just giving the notes today. So go through it. And if you have any problem, you can ask. Otherwise, I will explain it tomorrow again. Okay. So almost time is over here. So I'm not continuing my class because you have your next class after this. Okay, students. And don't.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't forget to give the attendance in Google form as early as possible. This is mandatory for you all.
Ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am, what you have shared in the text, ma'am, that jam files. Yeah. I mean, the text you have shared some Jamboard files, ma'am. What are that?
Jamboard file from Google. Yes. Meet I wrote to there from Google Meet one option na whiteboard.
Okay,
in Google Meet I have my laptop is touch screen, so that I can write it by my hand. One word whiteboard I am selecting from there, Jamboard, and there just my finger I am writing. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
If it is, if I ordered this thing, that is that tab and pen, so there I will write then. But as it is your maths class, that is totally depending on mathematics. So for that, I go from the Google Meet. If you go to Google Meet, you can just search. You will get it there. In Google Meet, you will get that one. See, turn on captions and you are presenting. One sign is there in Google Meet. You are presenting. So you in beside you are presenting, you will get three dots. Okay. Here, can you see my mark? Three dots are there. After just beside you are presenting, three dots are there. If you go to the three dots, then you will get the jam board or whiteboard. So click there. And share if you are sharing the Jamboard, then the students can share, just see that what is written there. So no problem. Okay, so just ending my class.